Swerkins.
Certainly, sir. If you follow the street to the end and turn right, you'll be in the market square.
You see her by your clothes and your urgent voice. I'd say you're on your way to meet your sweetheart.
Oh, well, as a matter of fact, I am.
Is she very beautiful, sir?
Well, she happens to be the dearest, the most precious thing in my life.
We'll not detain you any longer. Good morning, sir.
Queen's sake, if we got here in time.
Hurry, D'Artagnan. We must get the Duke to the palace at once. The Queen will be waiting anxiously.
Aramis, Porthos, Athos.
Oh,
where's the other lad? Porthos, get on.
How are you?
Did you see me, D'Artagnan? It only took me 10 seconds to get her phone number. It'll take you the rest of the show.
Yeah,
and
me,
Dad.
I fought off several of them.
Seven?
Yeah, like
gangsters.
Your mind,
D'Artagnan. The
Tories.
It'd make great photographers.
Wait.
They're not fully developed,
Jim. Listen, I want you three to take the Duke to the palace. There's not a moment to lose, and the Queen is waiting.
Hurry.
Thank you, D'Artagnan. I shall relay your brave deeds to your Queen.
Hurry, Your Grace.
Constance, you know I'd do anything for you. I'd gladly give my life for you if it meant winning your love. From the first moment I saw you, I fell in love with you.
You're so courageous, D'Artagnan. There's no need to give your life, for you already have my love.
But I have nothing to give you. I have no money, no possessions. I'm not even a musketeer.
How foolish are you, D'Artagnan? I don't want your money or your possessions. All I want is you.
Do you really mean that?
With all my heart.
I shall serve you and the Queen of my life.
Yeah.
about us. Constance was to have him here as soon as he arrived in Paris.
Maybe your lady-in-waiting Constance has betrayed you, Your Majesty.
Remember, the Count de Rochefort has spies everywhere.
Yes, I know he has, Countess. But only Constance, you and I knew of the Duke's intentions to visit me here in Paris.
Surely you're not suggesting that it was I that betrayed you?
My dear Countess, I'm not suggesting anything. But as you pointed out, the Count's spies, they're everywhere.
And friend await an audience.
Oh, show them in! Quickly, hurry! At last, my love has arrived.
Majesty, may I present D'Artagnan of Gascony, the most loyal subject in all of France.
Your Majesty, it's an honour for me to serve you.
I welcome you, D'Artagnan of Gascony. But where is the Duke of Buckingham?
He will be along presently, as soon as his escort arrives.
His escort? Why? What has happened?
Nothing too serious, I hope.
The Duke was ambushed in the Market Square last night by the Count of Rochefort and the Cardinal's guard.
Is he injured? Has any harm come to him?
Maybe the Count has killed him, Your Majesty!
Calm yourself, Your Majesty. The Duke is fine. D'Artagnan fought off six of the Cardinal's guards to protect him.
Didn't he even get swarmed?
No, Countess. The Duke is fine. Thanks to D'Artagnan.
Indeed, D'Artagnan, you are a brave and loyal subject. Ask me what you will, and it shall be yours.
All I want, Your Majesty, is to see you and the Duke happy together.
Yes, you and the Duke.
Only a true subject would say such a thing.
Your Majesty, the Captain of the Musketeers.
Your Majesty, I have grave news. The Count of Rochefort and his Cardinal's Guards have just hatched an English spy.
An English spy?
How can this be grave news, Captain? Spies are enemies, and all enemies should be put to death.
I'm glad to hear the welfare of France is most upper in your mind, Countess. Tell me more of this English spy, Captain.
Well, Your Majesty, it is rumoured that he is none other than the Duke of Buckingham, the Prime Minister of England.
Now, Captain, are you sure this is the Duke?
I give you my word as a musketeer, sir.
Guard!
What?
Guard!
What happened to you now? What happened to you?
We were ambushed in the Market Square as we left.
Ambushed?
Yeah. The Count and his men. There must have been 50
Yeah, they reminded me of that Irish football manager fella, you know that Clapatoli. Reminded me of him, because he was arrested for smashing up a cigarette machine.
No, they wanted those 20 players.
Well, mind him, D'Artagnan. Keep that. He's so stupid. He put a pack of dolls on top of the tent.
Why did you do that?
You're not the area, you see.
Leave now, but take
those
to the palace. I may meet you and your friends soon again.
Very well, Majesty. Constance knows where to find me should you require me.
Yes,
yeah,
she'll see you safely
to
Mayday.
Did you
get
back to Dublin?
Yeah.
Oh,
I'm
from
Dublin. Sorry.
Count of Rochefort, what is the meaning of this? Cardinal, what are you doing here?
Your Majesty, I trust you have heard of the great deed I have done for our country today. Capturing the English spy.
Such matters are upon your head, Count. That is the Queen's affair.
I beg to differ with you, Captain. Such matters are for the Court of France to decide.
Yes, spies are spies, especially English spies.
But of course, if Your Majesty has something to hide by a particular capture of this spy,
in which case the charge would be considered one of high treason.
How dare you suggest that I, Queen Anne-Marie of France, am a traitor?
Enough! We will let the Court of France decide.
Call in the Court of France!
All bow to the Majesty Queen.
Get on with it, Count. Do your evil deed, I say.
Bring in the prisoner.
Bring in the prisoner.
Here you see before you, my lords and ladies of the court, the English spy, the Duke of Buckingham, whom I captured less than 100 yards from this very castle. Who knows, perhaps he was sent here to kill our beloved Queen Anne-Marie. Now I ask all of you, what shall be done with this man?
Well, I say, Count, we should put him to death.
I too say we should put him to death.
Death to the spy, off with his head.
Will Her Majesty pass sentence on the spy, Buckingham? May I remind Your Majesty that if you do not pass sentence, you too will be held for high treason in the Bastille.
We are waiting, Your Majesty.
All of France is waiting, Your Majesty.
This is a mean trick, Count. What do you pay dearly for?
Will Her Majesty pass sentence?
I, Queen Amory of France, hereby sentence you, George Duke of Buckingham, to face death tomorrow morning in the market square.
This is the hour I have been waiting for. And tomorrow morning in Her Majesty's court, you shall die, die, die! Such a shame, it has to end. I have plans, but you're not in them. Say goodbye, my youthful friend.
Mademoiselle Mimi.
Bonjour,
Mademoiselle Mimi.
Comment
allez-vous? Why did Humpty Dumpty have a great fall? To make up for the bad summer. What do you call an old snowman? That's panto for you, isn't it? You just don't know what's going to happen. A puddle. These two guys were discussing their boss's upcoming wedding, you see. And one lad said to the other, it's absolutely ridiculous. He's rich. He's 93. And he's marrying a young one of 26. What kind of a wedding is that? It's a football wedding, says his friend. She's waiting for him to kick off. Girls, are there many girls in tonight? Hands up the ladies. Some of you are afraid to put your hands up. Men, what would we do without them? Right pain, aren't they? Yes. Mental anguish, mental anxiety, Why don't men die in their sleep? Because they can't do two things at the same time. How do men exercise at a beach? By sucking in their belly every time they see a bikini. Men are like high heels. Easy to walk on once you get the hang of it. Wait till I tell you about the balloon family, will I? Mammy Balloon and Daddy Balloon were in bed this particular night. A very cold night it was. Snuggled into each other, you see. And next door you had Baby Balloon. And of course, Baby Balloon wakes up with the cold in the middle of the night and comes racing, well, floated into Mammy right? And tried to snuggle in between the two of them, you see, but couldn't really fit, so Baby Balloon leaned down and let a little bit of air out of himself like that, you see. Still couldn't manage to snuggle in, so he bent down and he let a little bit of air out of Daddy, you see. Still it wasn't right, so he bent down and let a bit of air out of Mammy, you see. And finally, snuggled in, lovely, sat back, snug as a bug. Next morning, Mammy and Daddy Balloon got up, went down for the breakfast, and Baby Balloon comes floating down, you see. And Mammy Balloon and Daddy Balloon were very upset. "We are very upset with what you did last night," they said. "What did I do?" said Baby Balloon. "Not only did you let yourself down, but you let your mammy down. And your daddy down as well." What's the difference between a man and a chimpanzee? One is hairy, smelly, always scratching himself, and the other is a chimpanzee. All my children, come to me. Oh! Oh, we I said that. Oh, I was so lucky. Oh, Aramis, you have some boy. Now, come to your mummy, come. Come to your poor, soft-spoken and give your mother an hug. Or I will kick your teeth in.
Oh. Well, that's not true.
I thought that would help. There we are. Now tell me.
How
do you want to die?
I want to die. From an overdose. Oh. Are you a gorgeous cooking man?
And how do you want to die?
I want to die at the age of 90, drowned in a vat of Irish whiskey. Look it up. Oh, you guys.
And how do you want to die, Aramis?
I want to die at the age of 101, shot by a jealous husband.
Now! What is all this talk about saving the Duke?
We can't be fast. Woo! Like lightning, D'Artagnan said.
Yeah, but there's a question, old mother.
What is it?
What's the fastest thing in the world?
I know.
Tussa.
Me.
Twa. Two.
You.
Electricity. Yes. Hello, I.
Why?
But you can turn on a light switch here, and a mile away up the road, a light will come on at the same time. Now that's fast.
No.
Huh? The blink of an eye. You can blink your eye several times in a second. So that's fast.
No. I think it's diarrhea. I had it last night and he didn't have time to flick a switch or blink an eye. You know?
What you watched it,
huh? You know diarrhea is hereditary.
Is it?
Oh. It runs through your genes. Now. Now, come, I will help you to rescue the Duke. Come to me, give me one more egg before we go. He should have gone to Specsavers.
But there's your mummy.
Constance, Your Majesty.
I have need of your service yet again, D'Artagnan.
Anything, my queen. Just ask it of me.
I was forced by the Count and the Cardinal of the sentencing of the Duke to be put to death.
And when is this foul deed to take place?
Dawn tomorrow, D'Artagnan. How will we save the Duke now? I fear it's too late. If anyone can, it will be D'Artagnan, Your Majesty.
Leave it to me, Your Majesty. I shall save the Duke of Buckingham for you. I pledge this with my life.
I have great faith in you, D'Artagnan. But now I can see you and Constance need to be alone. I know two young lovers when I see them, Your Majesty. I feel so ashamed. But what could I do? If I could, I would gladly change places with him.
That the English spy, Duke of Buckingham, faced death by beheading today in this square. And it has been entrusted to me to carry out this sentence. Do you have any last words to say before your demise?
I only want to say this. I am no spy. I love your queen, and I only want peace between your country and mine.
Enough. Stop the drums.
What is going down for?
We have hit a hill.
Then why have we stopped?
I think Mary Harron is just after getting on.
Oh, you look at the Count, huh? His mouth is so big, he could sing a duet all by himself.
He looks like he swallowed a frog.
Will it make him sick?
Sick? He's not even a crow, can he, man?
He has a head on him like a box of Lego. In bits.
This man is so ugly, right? So ugly that when he was born, the doctor sacked his mother instead of him.
Enough of this tomfoolery. Guards, seize those musketeers.
Oh, you will not seize those musketeers. I will be got out of you. I will scatter your teeth from here as far as Neeson's. Bah! Don't you dare.
Neeson's?
Yes.
Spell Neeson's.
N-E-E-S-O-N-S.
Yes, I think you'll find it's pronounced McDonald's.
Look! A distraction! Name the Queen! Arrest the Duke!
Seize those musketeers! Stop the cannon! Get them!
Oh, we won the day. I better hurry back to my tavern. I don't want Count Cummins to take on my customers. Discovered a new website last week, www.conjunctivitis.ie. A site for sore eyes. Anyhow, my computer needed a password with 8 characters, do you see? So I typed in Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. John Wayne, well, I'll tell you about John Wayne. John Wayne arrives in town this particular day, ties up his horse outside a saloon. Goes into the saloon and says, "Give me a shot of red eye." That's whiskey. So the bartender gives him a shot of red eye, drinks it up, goes outside. Horse disappeared. Got it. Came back into the saloon again. He says, "If my horse isn't back, by the time I drink my next shot of red eye," he says, "the same thing that'll happen here, that happened in God City. Give me another shot of red eye." Drinks the shot of red eye, goes outside. Sure enough, the horse is back where he left him. Gets up on the horse, and this cowboy runs over him. He says, "What happened in God City, John?" "I had to walk home." Now it's back to the script. "Oh, D'Artagnan, you're the bravest man I have ever known, D'Artagnan. Oh, and I've known a lot of them good boys, D'Artagnan. Oh."
"And I owe my life to D'Artagnan."
"You do?"
"Take nothing out of my mouth. I fight always on the side of justice."
"Take my lord Duke, he's riding being the Queen's Musketeer."
"Indeed I do, Constance. And when I see the Queen again, I shall recommend it to her."
"Hooray!"
"And now I think we should have a little bit of a dance. I sing some. Every day I'm shoveling, shoveling, shoveling. Every day I'm shoveling, shoveling."
"Are you serious?"
"What is the problem?"
"Shoveling.
Oh, shuffling. So I hear it, yeah. Shuffling, shuffling.
More like every day I'm struggling.
Oh,
but first, a toast.
A toast.
To the bravest man in all of France.
To the bravest man in all of France.
To that canyon.
To that canyon. Oh, did you see the look on the Count's face when my hero, that canyon, charged in? Oh, he had a face on him like a bulldog chewing a nettle.
Well, I was so glad you saved me, D'Artagnan.
I thought Porthos, Athos, and Aramis did a wonderful job distracting the Count.
Yes, they did, but where are they now? They should be here celebrating this.
Oh, here they come now.
Oh.
Oh. What happened to the three of you?
It was awful, Mammy.
What was awful?
It was terrible!
What was terrible?
He took us completely by surprise!
Yeah, ma. How many savages are?
Was it the Count and his men?
No, it wasn't them, D'Artagnan.
Then who was it that attacked you?
There was three. Three of the most gorgeous British stuff I've seen in a lifetime!
Oh, no wonder you wouldn't fight them off.
But
my one was a blonde.
Bombshell she was. Like all the McLaughlin down there.
He is not blonde.
Beautifully.
Right. Mine, mammy. Mine. Mine was a rusty raven head like Mosto. No, that's not right.
Mine was a bloodshot grenade. Like Mac Trudle.
Sorry,
not
McNamara.
Sorry,
she looks 19.
19. Oh, that is definitely a joke. What would a girl of 19, that was the line. What would a girl of 19 know about love?
Oh, Dana. More than much good for her. Enough of this. You're never ready.
What?
The next line. What?
Oh, enough. Now look what you're after doing to me, huh? Oh, enough. I don't want to hear any more of this talk. Your poor papa wouldn't like to be listening to this. God be good to him.
See, he went when he died,
Madame. Oh, he left me a tavern with no roof on it. A dose of the German measles. And, of course, a tax bill as huge as Enderkin's. And these three idiots.
Madame,
oui, oui.
I knew your husband
well. Oh, you have a nice accent.
I do. I copy it very well. You used to bring him.